And the Masters in Applied Islamic Thought is as much a central developmental project here at IPSA as it is of the life work of Dr. Jasser. And clearly from a investment perspective, a lot of personal investment, a lot of intellectual investment, and a lot of professional investment went into the development of that program from Dr. Jasser. And so from IPSA's side, we are eternally grateful and indebted to him for having also, in a sense, taken us by the hand in this particular path and helping us to realize who we are and to fulfill who we are in ways that would be more effective and be more successful for us as Muslims in the Cape in particular. And I wish to make that point in the Cape in particular, and then in the rest of our country in general. Because this project of the Maqasid al-Sharia, I recall Dr. Jasser having a lot of conversations with us in this particular regard, that there is really a place in the world, there is really a place in the world where a project of this nature could be as successfully rolled out as we would have it here right at the Cape. And much of that has got to do with our recent history. As the people that have just gone through their own struggles of political emancipation, the freedom that we've recently achieved, and all of those wonderful structures from a political and government perspective, which we all, and there are many people here also, you know, Zima, Ahmed is able to confirm that, I am certain. The benefits that we enjoy as a Muslim community that I think really also we really appreciate what we have. And so through these programs, I think what, I would fail in my duty. This morning, Dr. Jasser and myself and Sheikh Dawood Blanche, we also had a meeting at the Muslim Judicial Council, wanting to also show and share a little bit more exactly what it is that we're doing. And so one of the things which really we are about is about the resurrection of a more authentic, authoritative concept of knowledge as per the Quran itself. And Dr. Jasser has obviously been at pains to demonstrate that this bifurcation and this dichotomy of religious and secular is what has dumped us as an ummah into such a crisis. And so we are really at a thought intellectual level crisis, as well as at a leadership crisis as a result. And we don't have to look very far, but to look at the Muslim world in the state that we find ourselves. And so when we're talking about resurrecting that original construct of knowledge, then we're talking about those often quoted ayat about إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ فَلَوْلَا نَفْرَ مِنْ كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ and all مِنْهُمْ طَائِفَ لِيَتَفَقَّهُ فِي الدِّينِ and all of those ayat. If you look at its actual context in which it appears, there, in those contexts, it has little to do with dini knowledge. And it has everything to do with a comprehensive concept of knowledge. A knowledge which is all integrative, recognition of Allah Ta'ala at the center of it, and of course with a value system of akhlaq of Islam. And so this is our project going forward. We also inquire and implore from yourselves to travel the journey with us. We need it. Jasser, Jazakumullah khairah. Thank you very, very much. I'm sure I speak on behalf of everyone here in this class. May Allah Ta'ala keep you safe to your family. And with love, respect, and honor. Allah. And
oh, wow, look at that.
Abdul Ghafoor and Aisha are going to do a vote defense on behalf of the registered students. And then Nazima is going to do something on behalf of the auditing students.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ما شاء الله شيخ Professor Dr. Jasser, on behalf of the students, the cohort here, alhamdulillah, we would like to extend a warm thanks, express our gratitude and appreciation for the most insightful presentation over this number of weeks, alhamdulillah. Indeed, most people, as have been expressed, appreciated greatly. Indeed, also you have agitated many, and alhamdulillah, in a most positive way, mashallah. And indeed, what we are seeing that will be that will be coming from this course is higher levels and quality and degrees of scholarship. Alhamdulillah, and that has already been the discussion. So with that, we express our thanks. We pray that Allah preserves you, increase you with beneficial knowledge, and that you may return here time and time again so that we can continue on this discourse, inshallah. On behalf of all the students, Aisha is going to hand over the...
I've seen this as well.
Yeah.
It's fantastic, wow. What do you say, you're brilliant?
Can we call everyone to come up for a photograph?
We first let Nazima say something. Nazima Ahmed is going to say something.
Thank you so much.
Before they take the picture, just give a second.
Okay. Right, so if you didn't sign your name, sign your name.
Most sincerely, on behalf of all of us. And I think for me, the one thing that really has stood out amongst many is your deep and palpable love of the Quran. And I think that, more than anything, has really touched our hearts in immeasurable ways. And I think that we've understood from your methodological approach that love was what drove you to inquire, and that through inquiry, you are seeking certainty. And so I think that has been profoundly impactful on all our lives. And I say this with unequivocally, that you have changed us forever. We will never be able to be alhamdulillah, the people that we came in here being, because you have asked us to be self-critical. You've asked us to challenge our own assumptions. And most importantly, you have challenged us to take personal responsibility for our engagement with the Quran, not mediated through other lenses, but the Quran. And I think my final comment is that you've also manifested to us the centrality of not using the Quran as a point of reference, but that it is the fulcrum of our lives, of our inquiry, and of our scholarship. And I think that IPSA is extraordinarily blessed to have you, because inshallah you are going to elevate the level of inquiry and scholarship to a level that will be unsurpassed in Islamic studies.
Muhammad Zahir said that he came all the way from Johannesburg. He wants to say something. All the way from Johannesburg, mashallah, and we were very happy to have him here.
I feel actually obliged to say something. I feel it will be rude if I don't say anything. So I'd like to thank both Dr. Jasser, Sheikh Hassan, and IPSA for arranging this program. And then to Dr. Jasser for accepting the invitation. I came here especially from Johannesburg. I left my wife and my kids. I left all the responsibilities. And alhamdulillah, it was worth it. And my message is before I came here, I saw the world as a very gloomy place. And we, as Sheikh Hassan alluded to our situation in that part of South Africa, is that everything is very gloomy. In the sense that as I say this with all respect and those who are observed to all my asatira, but we live in a time of lots of challenges and fitna, and what the result they say is very difficult to be a practicing ideal Muslim. And I think everyone would agree with me that after attending your discourse, is that there's actually no excuse for not being a good ideal Muslim despite our circumstances. It's just we need to rise to the challenge. I think we've been living really mediocre. And that's why I think we've always had a sense of defeat. And alhamdulillah, may Allah grant you lots of barakat in your all your endeavors for bringing this realization to me. Perhaps others had it already, but alhamdulillah, this has been my personal experience with you. JazakAllah khairan.
Come forward for a photo because the ladies are still signing the gift box, so all the gentlemen come to the front of the apartment.
Let's have a group photo. Here is Stefan, Mans, and Kroons.
We don't have any sign.
Now you want to send a group photo? Yes, you can have a send group photo also. Ladies, please. The ladies in front, before we go. Let us do the photos. This is part of the protocol. It's part of the protocol. We will take care of them now, don't worry. We don't worry too much about the men as long as the women are in front. The women must lead. Let the women fall through also straight down there on the side. Fatima, can you just remove the wire?
He's going to take one now.
How is that looking? Are you coming, Gordon?
Can you take one?
The mashayikh in the back, is there any problem that you have with the taswir? كل مصور في النار ولا مش عارف يعني ما هذا مولانا شعيب is even here.
Freestyle.
Jasser, I'm sure you've gotten a lot of that over the past year.
Everything I could possibly feel about what you said was said even better than what I'm
Ashnuna. Ashnuna.
Everyone just announce it. Okay. Everyone, there's some refreshments in the cafeteria outside. Just exit the door, turn to your left to the cafeteria. Some refreshments will be served there.